Here's a look at your headlines. Daily rain chances returned this week with some heavier rain across Texas. So we're going to be just on the outside of where that heavier rain is going to be. It'll be warmer and more humid, especially as we go toward the end of the week. Here's all the rainfall right now across Texas. And as it continues to kind of build toward the east, a lot of this is going to diminish. But we may start to see some showers developing as we go into the early morning hours tomorrow. As you look at the wider view, we have high pressure off toward the east. The system just kind of stalled across the central plains. And so that's why this onshore flow is just going to continue. And I think we're just near that area of high pressure to help keep those rain chances a little bit lower as we go into next week. But we are going to see some scattered showers starting into the morning tomorrow. A few areas may see some rain or an isolated storm, and that continues through the morning and into the afternoon. And then we'll get to kind of in a daily afternoon pattern, kind of like what we see during summertime, where we see chances for rain and storms. Still showing some showers. It's a lot of S's over toward Baton Rouge by midnight on Tuesday. But otherwise, you'll see it calming down a bit as we go into Tuesday morning. More rain starts to move in, and that continues into the afternoon. So what we'll have to watch out for is that locally heavy rain each afternoon. And so that's where the flooding potential could be, but overall not a very organized flooding event expected. Here's the setup though. There's the high pressure off toward the east, and so onshore flow, you can see we're just kind of on the outside edge of that, because look just to the east. It's very dry across most of Mississippi, Alabama, Georgia, into Florida, with that heavy rain really concentrated closer toward where that low is. And so that's where we are looking at the heaviest rain, although just being on the outer periphery of it, if this moves even a little bit more toward the east, we could really see those totals adding up. So there is a little bit of uncertainty with the forecast going into next week. I would just count on that chance for some daily rain. We don't want a lot of rain. Our month to date is over 11 inches of rain, and right now we are in the top five of wettest Mays on record. Sounds like deja vu, because in April we were in the top five. So kind of a pattern shaping up for us here with that heavy rainfall. Summer is coming 35 days away. That's when the average high is 91 for June 20th. Right now, not seeing any 90s, though, so not looking too bad for us. But we will start to get warmer as we head toward Thursday and going into Friday. And that's because that high I mentioned that's been off to the east, it's going to creep a little bit back more toward the west. So it's going to lower our rain chances going into the weekend. But that means our temperatures are going to be going back up as well. As you see our forecast going into next weekend, this is next Sunday. You see some 90s from Georgia to Florida, some upper 80s, Jackson going into the New Orleans metro area. And with it being a little more humid, it's going to feel a little hotter as well. No 90s today, though. High temperatures mainly in the low to the mid 80s. So as we look at your 7-day forecast again, 30 to 40% rain chance, up to a 50% on Tuesday. Those scattered showers continue through about Thursday. It gets a little drier, but much warmer as we go toward next weekend.